How's it going, everybody? It's your bro here, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to be teaching you guys about some simple collision detection using Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Alright everybody, so collision detection. This is defined as the computational problem of detecting the intersection of two or more objects. So what we're going to be doing for this lesson is that we're going to create two rectangles, and we're going to determine if these two rectangles are colliding or not. So one is going to be player controlled. We can actually move this rectangle around, and the other is going to be just stationary. It's going to be more of an obstacle. And then if these two objects intersect or collide, then we'll just display a message such as game over. So this is just going to be a very simple example of collision detection. So let's begin by creating a few classes. So within my source folder, I'm going to go to File, New, Class, and I'm going to create a class called MyFrame, and MyFrame will extends JFrame. And then we're going to create another class, and we'll call this Box. And then Box will extends the Rectangle class. And then we're going to customize these boxes. One is player controlled and the other will be an obstacle. And then make sure we get these imports as well. Okay, let's create an instance of our MyFrame class. So we type in the name of the class, MyFrame. I'll call this MyFrame equals new MyFrame. And then let's complete our box class because there's not a lot to do within here. So let's begin by creating the constructor for this class. So we just type in the name of the class. We're going to be using a key adapter within the MyFrame class. So we'll create a method called public void key pressed. And then the parameter is key event E. And then we will create a draw method. So public void draw, and the parameter for this is graphics G. Okay, let's declare one thing before our constructor, just a color. So color, color. Okay, then for our constructor, we're going to set up a few parameters. So int x, int y, int width, int height, and color, color. So I'm just going to import everything related to java.awt, as well as everything related to awt.event. Alright, so what we're going to be doing with the constructor for this box is that we're going to pass in the x and y coordinates, the width and the height of this box, as well as a color whenever we instantiate a box object. So we'll type in this x equals x, whatever value we receive here. So this y equals y, this width equals width, this height equals height, and this color equals color. Okay, now within the key pressed method, we're going to create a few if statements. If e.get key code is equal to key event dot vk underscore up. So if somebody types the up button, we want to move the y coordinate for this box. So this dot y equals y, maybe minus 10 pixels. Now let's repeat this process for the other directions. So vk underscore down equals this y equals y plus 10. And then key event left equals this x equals x minus 10. And lastly, vk underscore right, this x equals x plus 10. And that is it for our key pressed method. So let's work on the draw method. So this one's fairly simple. We just need two lines of code. We're going to set the color. So G, that's our graphic that we have here. G.setColor, this.color. And then G.fillRect. Let me fix that real quick. FillRect. So we're going to take the x coordinate, this x, and then this y, this width, and this height. So whenever we call the draw method, we're going to basically be redrawing this object, our box. Okay, that is everything for this box class. So let's move on to MyFrame. So make sure you have all of these imports at the top. We only need three. And then let's declare all of the methods that we'll need. So we'll need the constructor for MyFrame. And then we'll need a paint method. So public void paint. And then make sure this paint method is lowercase. And then there's a parameter, graphics G. We're going to create a method called check collision. So public void check collision. And then we're actually going to create an inner class. So public class, and this will be an action listener. We'll call this AL for short. And it's going to extends key adapter. All right, so let's declare a bunch of things before our constructor so that they're globally available. So we're going to create an image object, image, as well as graphics, and we'll call this graphics. We'll create a box object called player and a box object called enemy. And we'll want a Boolean value called game over. Okay, let's move on to our constructor now. We'll finish initializing everything here. So player equals a new instance of our box class. And with this constructor, we have a few arguments that we need to pass in: the coordinates, the dimensions, and a color. So we'll place maybe 100 for the x coordinate, 300 for y, and this will be 50 by 50 for the dimensions, and a color, so maybe color.blue. Likewise, the enemy will be red. So for our enemy, enemy equals, we'll place this where x is 400, we'll keep these the same, except for the color. We'll just make the enemy red. And then game over equals false. And then let's work on our JFrame. So this dot set default close operation JFrame dot exit on close. So this allows us to close out of the program. And let's set the size for this frame. So this dot set size 600 by 600 is decent. We'll want to set the visibility to true. So set visible true. And then we're going to create an instance of our action listener class. So this dot add key listener. And we're going to pass in an anonymous AL class for action listener. We're basically passing in a instance of this, but we still need to fill this in. So that's coming up. Now let's move on to the body of our paint method. So this paint method is going to be called when we instantiate a new instance of this class. So, and we can also repaint things too. So that's kind of convenient. We just use the repaint method. So let's begin by saying that our image equals create image. And then we'll need dimensions for this image. So our image is going to be kind of like our game window. So we'll set the dimensions. So this dot get width So this is the width of the frame that we have. And this dot get height. And then we're also going to create our graphics. So graphics equals our image dot get graphics. And then lastly, G, which is our graphics dot draw image. And then there's a few arguments to pass in. We're going to pass in our image. The coordinates, we'll just start this in the top left corner. And then we need to pass in our frame, so this. Okay, let's draw the player and the enemy. So player, and we're going to use the draw method that we have. And we're going to pass in G, our graphics. And then we're also going to draw our enemy. It's about time we check to see what we have so far. So here's our player, our blue box, and here's our enemy, the red box. So they're at least displaying within our frame, but we can't yet move our player character, the blue box. So we're going to actually fill in a few things within our inner class, AL, short for Action Listener. So we're going to be overriding a method, so it's good practice to type in at override. And this method is called public void key pressed. And the parameter is key event E. So if somebody presses a key, we have a few things to do. First, let's move our player character. So we can actually call the key pressed method of our player object. So we're basically going to be calling this method right here. And depending on what the user types in, we'll move our character, the blue box. So player.key pressed, and we're going to pass in our key event E. Then let's check for a collision, but we still have to fill in this method. So check collision. And lastly, we're going to use the repaint method, and that will basically do all of this over again. Okay, let's see if we can actually move our player now. Yep, and it appears that we can. However, if we do collide into the enemy, we'll probably want to do something. So what we'll do is we will first check to see if there's a collision. So within here, we're going to type in if player, and there's actually a method for the rectangle class. So our box extends rectangle, and this method is called intersex. And we're going to check to see if this object intersects another object. We want to check to see if we are intersecting the enemy object. So if we are, what we're going to do is that we're going to take our game over boolean value and set this to true. And then let's also just print line this just to test it. So game over. So this will display in the console window. So let's try this again. All right, here we are. We can move around. I'm actually going around the enemy. Nothing's happening. But when I intersect it, it says game over in our console window. Let's take a look at this intersex method to understand the code underlying it. So intersex is a method of the rectangle class. So what we're doing is comparing two objects, and in our case, our player and our enemy. And what we're doing within this method, one, we're retrieving the dimensions for each of these objects, this as in the player, and R as in the object that we're comparing this to, our enemy. And here, we're retrieving the coordinates of where these objects are located spatially. And at the end, we're returning a Boolean value. And these few lines right here, what we're doing is determining if these two objects are intersecting between certain points within our frame. So if you need to, you can actually copy all of this code here and repurpose this for something else. Maybe if you want to check to see if two labels are intersecting or colliding, you can actually just copy all of this code and then just make a few changes where you're comparing the dimensions for these two labels and their x coordinates and y coordinates. But since we're using this rectangle class, we don't actually have to type all of that out. We can just use the intersex method because that's all done for us. So this is just a very basic demonstration of this. So one last thing I want to do is that we want to display game over like on our game frame. So what we'll do is within the paint method, we'll check to see if game over is equal to true. The shorthand way is just typing in game over. And within this if statement, we'll type in g.set color, maybe to red. Color.red. And then let's set the font. So g.set font new font. I'll pick MV Bully. Doesn't matter what you pick. And font.plain if you want a plain font, as well as a size. So maybe 45. And we need to type in g.drawString. And we will type in what we want to display the text. So game over, the x coordinate and the y coordinate. So maybe 150 as well as 100. Okay, that should be everything. Let's run this. So we have no problems. We're moving along, but as soon as we run into this red box, it displays game over. And then you can like disable this or exit out of the program if you want, but we'll save that for another day. So yeah, that's some simple basic collision detection. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics for collision detection using Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.